In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Pre-Algebra free worksheet, reading and writing whole numbers. So we're going to write each as a numeral for numbers 1 through 15. So let's jump in to number 1. The number 7 million, we're dealing with the millions place, so we know we're going to have at least 2 commas. So starting at the ones, we can do ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, hundred thousands, and then here we're at the millions and it says 7 million. So 7 million. That's how you would write number 1. Another way to think about this is it's only telling us that we have 7 million and nothing else. So in that millions place we'll have a 7 and the rest will be zeros. In number 2, we have 5,040,000. So I'll start on the left-hand side. So writing 5 million, and there's nothing else until the 10,000 place because 40 is in that tens place. So 5,040,000. If you need to, think of this as 2 separate numbers. We have 5 million, and we're adding that to 40,000. So 5,040,000. And number 3, we have 4,030,000. So we know we have 4 million and 30. And 30 is written with a 3 in the tens place and a 0 in the ones place. So I'll write 4,030,000. 4,030,000. In number 4, we have 400,004,000. 4 will be in the ones place, and we'll have a 4 in the 100 millions place. So this is 400,004,000. 400,004,000. For number 5, we just have 400 million. So we're going to have a 4 in the 100 millions place. So that's 400 and then 6 more zeros after that original 400. 400 million. In number 6, we have the number 9,191. So we have a 9 in the thousands place, and then we have 191. So a 9 in the thousands place, and then 191. 9,191. For number 7, we have 1,380. So we're going to have a 1 in the thousands place, and then 3 in the hundreds place, 8 in the tens place, and 0 in the ones place. So that's 1,380. And remember, don't forget your commas separating thousands from the hundreds, tens, and ones, or the thousands from the millions if we were going up that high. For number 8, 50,000, so that's 50,290. So there's going to be a 5 in the 10,000 place, so 50 for 50,000, and then a comma followed by 290, so 290. So here is our 50,290. 50,290. For number 9, we have 70,600. So that's going to be a 70 in that thousand section. So 70,000 and then a 6 in the hundreds place. 600. 70,600. For number 10, we have 972,003. So we have 972,000. So that's 972,000. But we also have a 3, which is a single digit in the ones place. So combining those, we'll have 972,003. For 11 through 15, we're going to have lengthier numbers. So walk through this with me. For number 11, we have 548 million. So 548 will be in our millions place. And then we will have 898,000. So a comma, then 898 for the thousands, and then 783. 783. So for number 11, our total number is 548,898,783. So for number 12, we're dealing with 791 million. 791 million, then a comma, 821,000. So 821,000, and then a comma, followed by 637. 637. So again, for number 12, we have 791 million. But as opposed to zeros, after that 791, we have 821,000. And as opposed to zeros, after the 821, we have 637. So again, that's 791,821,637. For number 13, we're writing the number 547 million. So that's 547 and then a comma. 286,000, so that's 286, and then another comma, and then 380. 380. So in total, 547,286,380. So for number 4, we have 667 million. 667 million. And that's followed by 272,000. So 272,000, and then finally 270, with commas in between each of those numbers. So that's 667,272,270. And for the last part in writing the numeric expression, we have 635 million. 635,844,000, so 844, comma, and then 494. So again, that's 635,844,494. So the millions is separated with a comma from the thousands, which is separated with a comma from the hundreds. So on the rest of this worksheet, we're going to do the opposite of what we were just doing. So here we're given the number and we're going to write the numeral in words. So looking at number 4, we can see we have 40 million and then 90. So this will just be 40 million separated with a comma and then 90. 40 million, 90. Let's go on to number 17. In 17, you can see we have 300 million and the only number that we have left is that 5, which is in the 10,000s place, so that's going to be 300,050,000. So again, 300 million, a comma, and then 50,000. For number 18, we have 1 million, just a 1 in the millions place. So it's 1 million. For number 19, we have 100 million and then 200,020. So you can think of reading each of these as separate sections between the commas. 100 million, then 200,000, and then 20. $100 million, then you write 200,000. And I'm running out of room, so scooting the page over, 100 million, 200,000, 20. So notice our speech or our written words are broken up with those commas just as well as the numbers are. So moving on to number 20, we have 680 in the millions section and nothing else. So this will just be 680 million. 680 million. And number 21, we have one comma that separates the thousands and the hundreds. So we have 19,000 and then 40, because that 4 is just in the tens place. So we write this as 19,000 with a comma and then 40. For number 22, we have 930,000, because that 930 is in that thousands section, and then we have a 10. So we write this as 930,000, 10. For number 23, we have a 2 and our thousands place, and then 482. So this is written as 2,000. Don't forget the comma. So that's 2,482. Now, there needs to be a hyphen between 80 and 2 by writing 509,000. So 509,650. We have 7,608. So we write this as 7,608. And number 26, we have 461 in our thousands section and 955 for hundreds, tens, and ones. So the way we write this will be 461, and just like between the tens and ones place, we write a hyphen between those digits if that thousands place or that ones place is not a zero and there is a number other than zero in our tens or ten thousands place. So 461,000. And that's followed by, I'm going to run out of room, so I'll write it on the next line, 950, don't forget that hyphen, and then 5. 461,955. And those hyphens just let us know that that 1 is not by itself and that 5 is not by itself. It's connected with the 61 and connected with that 55. So on to number 27, we have 318,950. And I want to note that we do not have to write a hyphen because 18 is its own word. That's different than 28 or 38, 48, 58, and so on. 18 is written slightly differently, and we do not need a hyphen for that. Same with other teens, such as 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and other special numbers such as 11 and 12. Those have their own written words different than our other patterns, such as think about 11 versus 21 or 31, or think about 12 versus 42 or even 62. So because 18 is a word in itself, we don't need a hyphen for that. So 318,000, 950. So again, in number 27, we have the number 318,950. In number 28, we have 638,000, and 38 is going to have a hyphen between the 30 and the 8, and then 530. So we write this as 638,530. Moving on to our second to last problem, number 29, we have 693, and that's 1,000 followed by 186. So there's going to be a hyphen between the 9 and 3 for 93, and a hyphen between 8 and 6 for 86. So we'll write this as 693,000, because that first comma separates that thousands. And then I'll write this on the next line since I'll run out of room. 186. 693,186. Now onto our last problem on this worksheet, number 30. You can see we have 88 in this thousand section, and then followed by 917. So that's going to be 88 with a hyphen, 1,000 representing 88,000, and then 917. 88,917 is our last answer on this worksheet. And before continuing on, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Also, feel free to go to my website, maemap.com, maemap.com, for more tutorials and, soon, math games. So again, that's maemap.com, maemap.com.